Hall. Derek Hall to Jose. Jose crossover, spins. A great shot. Rayma Jose, the man who went to Far Eastern University and studied sports management.
The Dragons again, Ben settling for an outside jump shot.
Rala Filipinas, as we are now up by 7, 25 to 18. Mitchell Coco against, oh, nice step back move by Coco, and he knocks it down.
Excellent move there against Bobby Ray Parks. Coco using his heft to create some space on the step back.
Things in life is to be different. It's not easy to step out and do something that the next person is not doing.
You know, I grew up as a kid, you know, looking at the NBA, dreaming hopefully one day I can get there. I grew up watching All-Star games and, you know, thinking that'd be cool, you know, if I can make it there. And now I'm 11 years in consecutively, so you try not to take it for granted. You know, you try to, you know, you understand that nothing is guaranteed to you. So I'm thankful.
Don't be afraid to be different, man. That's what make your own way stands for. Your way. Everybody's is different. Everybody got a different story. You might be from the same block. You might be from the same park, the same neighborhood, whatever the case may be. But everybody got a different path.
I think what Dwayne and Li Ning are doing for these kids is unbelievable, man. I think we need more of those type of people that are not afraid to sacrifice something that's cool for something that can have a positive effect on so many others, and most importantly, a younger generation.
D-Wade coming to my high school, it means the greatest thing in the world, basically. And he's giving back to me, like this room, before he gave back to this room, it was really small. Now it just looks excellent, it looks the best. And D-Wade coming to my school, personally, that's just the greatest thing to ever happen, because most people, when they make it, they don't come back.
What these kids get to learn in these moments is not just how to put a ball in a hoop. They learn how to be themselves, be confident and competent in any arena. It's coming, it's coming.
Make your own way to me kind of is kind of like paving your own path to greatness.
Be a leader, kind of follower.
To inspire other people to lead by example.
Challenging my team to find the need in the community, you know, with that youth. And, you know, going around and trying to, you know, figure it out, man. And, you know, we always try to leave an impact. You know, every time we come to a city, I know how important that is. You know, it can be something small, man. Just by seeing someone come to your school or see someone care about you enough, it can change your whole outlook on life. You know, so I've been there before and I get it.
Against the likes of the Westports Malaysia Dragons, whom they will be facing on Sunday.
Great win indeed for the home team, the Kaohsiung Truth. They are playing inspired basketball, and we saw in that game, the 1st of February, Coach Marco, that not only the World Imports came out to play, the Heritage Imports,
number 15,
at least for Kaohsiung Truth, also did well.
Well, Rayma Jose, we all know, everybody knows him from his playing days in the UAAP, especially our Filipino viewers. Came out big in that game, 16 points, 6 rebounds, 2 assists. What we like about Rayma Jose's game is he gets into the head of his opponents. That time it was against David or Viet Arnold. Really took him off his game, scored 7 points in the second quarter, 7 points as well in the third quarter. He was the X factor, and that is why he came away with the Player of the Game honors.
Now going over to the Singapore Slingers, our visiting team, the number one team in the ABL right now. You mentioned that we were talking off the air, 20-day rest for the visiting team. But let's look at their bright spots, the players who will be under the microscope for this game.
Well, of course, you have Justin Howard and Xavier Alexander, who are the main guns for them. But I think for me, the couple of players who will be key for them, Desmond Oh comes off the bench, hits big shots against Hong Kong. He hit a big triple in the fourth quarter, close to the last 2 minute mark, really stifled that run of Hong Kong. And then of course you have Leon Kwek, who is playing exceptional basketball for them, finished with 19 points in that game, had 8 rebounds as well and 4 steals. They call him Leon the Lionheart, and he's going to play a crucial role here against the hot shooting Kaohsiung Truth.
I always ask you this, Marco, the world imports will definitely show up. The heritage imports are expected to show up as well, but local support, we've seen this in Kaohsiung Truth, we've seen this in Singapore Slingers. How crucial are the locals in their campaign?
Well, definitely they're going to be important because the way they're called and Cedric Oliver for Kaohsiung have been playing, they might eliminate they might just cancel out each other. Talking about Justin Howard and Xavier Alexander for the Slingers and Hall and Oliver for the Kaohsiung Truth. So it'll be up to the locals for Singapore. Wong Wei Long, we know, former local MVP, Leon Kwek, Desmond Oh. For the Kaohsiung Truth, it might be the heritage imports. You have Raymar Jose, you have Achin Ego. Of course, you have Shin, who just came off a great game, had 6 points in that game against Saigon. And then you have Jay Wei, and you also have Chang, who might snipe it from the outside. So, of course, the supporting cast will be very crucial for both teams.
Let me pick your brains further. How will Coach Neo Beng Siam of the Singapore Slingers adjust to the defense of Kaohsiung Truth? It seems like the zone defense is doing well for the home team.
Well, I think Coach Neo Beng Siam, having the more veteran team, I think they will stick to their game plan. We saw against Hong Kong Eastern Long Lions, they tried to get the ball inside first to Justin Howard. He is their pivot, or he is the anchor of their offense. Make the defense, whether it's a 2-3 zone or a man-to-man, make that defense react. Try to force them to double-team Justin Howard. And we've seen that Howard has been very willing and very selfless to kick out to his open shooters, Desmond Oh, Leon Kwek, Wong Wei Long, who have obliged, hitting, I believe Leon Kwek shot 60% from the field in their last game against Hong Kong. So we've seen Howard, we've seen Xavier Alexander facilitate for their teammates, and that is one of the reasons why the supporting cast for Singapore will be very key.
The protagonists have been introduced. Our referees are Bong Pascual from the Philippines, Wai Siong Chan from Malaysia, and Natapong Jontapa from Thailand.
Thank you.
There you have it, the national anthem for both squads. We always do it that way, part of our protocol. And now that we are done with the formalities, expect this gymnasium, the Kaohsiung Municipal Senior High School Gymnasium, to be packed with action for today's match. Number one, Coach Marco, Singapore Slingers going up against current number four, Kaohsiung Truth. And it's actually scary, I believe, for the two other teams at the bottom of the standings, because the Truth are now finding their form as we go deep into the elimination round.
That is true, Chicky. You know, with the addition of two heritage imports in Raymar Jose Achinigo, though Inigo has been injured for the past two games, they've really beefed up the lineup of Coach Sabatino Chen. Also the addition of Jay Wei playing really better for them, and as well as Shin, who has entered at the starting spot with an injury to Achi Inigo. They're playing more as a team. I think they are also playing better defense. Offense as well, improving for them. Their outside shooting is going to be key. We talk about outside shooting, you cannot not mention Wesley Su at 15 points in their game against Saigon last Wednesday. He was 2 out of 3 from the three-point area. And when Singapore starts to pack it inside the paint, we know that they love to keep Justin Howard patrolling that middle. The guys on the outside, Wesley Su, Luo, whether it's Achi Inigo, and even Cedric Oliver, who might play on the outside, as well as Derek Hall, they will be crucial to draw the defense out.
We had a quick chat earlier with Wesley Su, and he's very happy with how things have progressed for their team. He mentioned to us that the first four games were probably, for them, it was like a preseason four games for them. And then slowly but surely, when they started changing things up, things just started to fall into place for Kaohsiung Truth.
Well, that is true. And we saw that in the first four games, they were experimenting on a couple of imports, experimenting on the lineups. It seems that right now they are finding that good rotation, especially under the tutelage of Coach Sabatino Chen, who was a former player. So things are looking up for the Kaohsiung Truth. And right now they are at the solo fourth spot, just 2 or 3 games behind Ala Pilipinas. Another win here in their next two home games will really solidify their hold on fourth spot.
Starting five for the Slingers: Wong Wei Long, Leon Quick, Xavier Alexander, Mitchell Folkong, and Justin Howard, big boy Justin Howard, manning the middle at the center position. While on the other side for the Kaohsiung Truth, we got Jay Wei, Wang Chin Kai, Wesley Su, Cedric Oliver, and Derek Hall, the usual suspects for both squads.
And you know, Chicky, even though we talked about the supporting cast, really both teams revolve around their starters. Four players for the Singapore Slingers average close to 67 out of their 79 points. That's Howard, Alexander, Quek, and Wong. They total about 67 points per game. For Kaohsiung, it's Oliver, Hall, Su, and Raymar Jose right now, totaling about 65 of the 82 points. They produced that much. So we're going to take a look at the starters, how these guys figure in this matchup, and we're going to see who comes out stronger and more aggressive of these two teams.
I am interested to find out this matchup between the big guys, Howard and Hall. I mean, height-wise, they might cancel each other off, but weight-wise and heft-wise, I gotta give it to Justin Howard.
Yes, heft-wise and strength-wise, also inside play, you might have to give it to Justin Howard. But these two players have very different types of games. Derek Hall likes to play more on the outside, likes to set this wing ball screen because he can pop to the three-point area. Was 2 out of 3 in their last game against Saigon, so expect him to try and draw Justin Howard to the perimeter.
Shin. Ball movement good for Kaohsiung Truth. Jay Wei, oh, that was an air ball.
It's been a little bit cold coming off the start of this ball game, but you saw the offense of Kaohsiung revolving on the perimeter. They're more of the perimeter-oriented team as compared to the Slingers.
Almost a minute has gone by here in the first quarter. Quick. That's an open shot. Too much of a space for Leon Quek.
That's almost automatic for Leon Quek. Quek averages about 14 points per game, shoots close to 50% from the field. This guy doesn't really take three-point shots, but he is very deadly in the mid-range.
Slingers up 2-0. Shot clock down to 9 for the Truth. Here comes Wei. Oliver with 5 to shoot. blocked there by Alexander Holhassett. He has to throw this one up. Oh, and it's good. We are tied at two.
This is a great shot there. Great offense. Lucky break here for Kaohsiung. And this is also another good matchup that we're looking at. Xavier Alexander against Cedric Oliver. That's one of the things where Singapore might have a slight advantage in terms of athleticism.
A miss there by Hall. Red shirts on the run. Folkoff changing direction. Finds Quick. Baseline jumper won't drop. And ball goes back to Kaohsiung. So we're expecting this, right, to be a fast-paced game between these two squads. Meantime, Shin has it with 12 on the shot clock.
Another good matchup here between Wong Wei Long and Shin, former local MVP, rather, talking about Wong Wei Long.
Now we found out as well that number three, Wang Shin Kai, is actually a celebrity here at Kaohsiung.
How many followers on Instagram, Chicky?
47,000. Wow.
He's at the 2-3 zone for the Kaohsiung Truth.
Uh-oh, Alexander underneath, and Oliver couldn't do anything about that.
And again, true to form for the Slingers. First option inside to Justin Howard, who loves to pass off of that double team, that time finding Xavier Alexander.
First 2 points for the 6-6 Alexander. Meantime, Shin against the Giant. Wesley has it with 8 to shoot. He uses the glass and we are tied at 4.
That's a good shot there for Wesley Su. So far, Kaohsiung not able to get a good flow to their offense. Great half-court defense by the Slingers.
The floater by Quick. They are not making it difficult for Leon Quick, at least in the first 3 minutes of the first quarter.
I was about to say, Chicky, too easy there for Leon Quick. He loves that spot on the baseline. He can either shoot it from about 15 feet or take it strong to the basket.
6-4, Slingers up by 2, and that's a turnover for the white shirts. Quickly, Oliver giving a low five to Derek Hall. Another look at this wise move, smart move coming from Wesley Su.
Great use of the board there, but early on, 2 turnovers already for the white shirts.
Howard with a miss, Oliver for the board.
That's something that the Truth will give Howard the entire afternoon. Just get a hand up if you're Derek Hall.
Meantime, Hall couldn't get that outside shot going. He has it now. Back to Oliver. And stolen by Alexander. On the other side, no rebounder, no problem for the Slingers.
And you notice how Cedric Oliver is having a hard time in his matchup against Xavier Alexander.
Wong Wei Long with that jumper. They have a 4-point lead, 8-4. Coach Sabatino Chen wisely calling this timeout to stop the bleeding. Kaohsiung Truth down by 4 with 6:14 remaining here. Continues here at the Kaohsiung Municipal Senior High School. We got a good crowd on a Friday afternoon. This is the match between the home team Kaohsiung Truth and the visiting Singapore Slingers. 8-4 is our score, Coach Marco, and so far so good for the number one team.
Yep, Singapore showing no signs of rust. They are 3 out of 5 rather from the field, and a great pass there from Raymar Jose, who came in for Wesley Su. So they're going to try to take advantage of Raymar Jose's matchup against Mitchell Folkoff in the post.
2-point lead here for Singapore, 8-6. They have possession inside the big boy Howard. The help, the miss, the battle for the rebound, a good tap coming from Hall.
And you know, that's a good defensive stop for the Kaohsiung Truth. Singapore, not really a great 3-point shooting team, but they're a very efficient scoring team within the three-point area. But there's the three-point range of Derek Hall. That's going to start drawing Justin Howard outside the paint.
If you're Justin Howard, you'll have second thoughts now in giving that open shot to Derek Hall.
But the more Justin Howard moves away from the paint, that's going to open up the lane for Raymar Jose or Cedric Oliver.
Lead swings back to Kaohsiung Truth, 9-8, because of that three by Hall. Empty possession for Singapore. Shin. Wei has it. Shot clock down to 12. They go to Hall. Open long two. It's good again.
And again, Derek Hall is going to shoot that the entire afternoon. He has the advantage in the perimeter against Justin Howard.
3-point lead here for Kaohsiung Truth. 5 straight points coming from Derek Hall. They swing it. One way long, back to Alexander. The three ball is out.
Okay.
Go to Shin, go ahead.
Alexander not really known for his three-point shooting, so good token challenge from Raymar Jose.
Mismatch here. Cedric shooting over Volkov, and it's also good.
That's all day for Cedric Oliver, just shooting above Mitchell Volkov.
This is a 9-0 run here by Kaohsiung Truth, starting with that great pass by Raymar Jose.
So that was a wise timeout called by Coach Sabatino Chen, and a good substitution putting Raymar Jose in.
4 minutes remaining in the first. Volkov with a miss. That was a bad tap coming from Derek Hall. Could have gotten that rebound.
And immediately he acknowledges to Coach Sabatino Chen that it was his mistake.
Another look at this three by Derek Hall, taking advantage of that space provided or given by Justin Howard.
And you see Howard not really in his comfort zone, going out of the painted area. But this is where he likes to thrive, going to the free throw line, although he's pretty much just a 60% free throw shooter, makes the first one.
They now have 9 points against the 13 of Kaohsiung Truth, with 3:56 to go here in the first. And Howard goes 2 of 2 in his first visit to the free throw line.
Check that, he's close to 70% from the free throw stripe. Takes roughly 7 free throw attempts per ball game. A little bit of pressure here for the red shirts.
Oh, good fake coming from Luo, and 2 points for the small guy on the floor.
That's the way to break that full court pressure, make them pay by scoring on them.
15-10, 11-2 run by the Truth. Red shirts with possession. Way long, the kick out to Alexander. They go inside to the big guy. Hanbin goes for the three. It's good.
That's a big shot there. Good kick out coming from Justin Howard. Hanbin Ng averages about 28%, or make that 30% from three.
Lead of Kaohsiung down to 2, 15-13. The pass to Jose deflected by Quick. And the Truth will keep possession with 8 to shoot.
That's good defense there coming from the Singapore Slingers. Here's that up fake. One dribble pull up off the glass from Luo.
Smart play indeed by the small guy. Meantime, Oliver has 5. He takes the jumper. It's short. Back to the red shirts. Alexander going hard to the cup, and we are tied at 15.
Almost very difficult to stop once Alexander gets a full head of steam.
15-all with 2:44 remaining here in the first. And Raymar Jose likes this matchup. However, referee Natapong John Tapa calls a double foul as we take another look at this drive by Alexander.
Loves to get it from outside, take it strong to the basket. One of the most athletic world imports we have here in the ABL. Meanwhile, on the other end, Raymar Jose feels he has that advantage in the post against Leon Quek.
Now, fresh pair of legs here for Coach Sabatino Chen. Sweet shooting. Chang Hao Chun is in for Jay Wei. Oliver has it. 7 to shoot. He'll take the short jumper, and this one will drop.
And again, as long as it's not Xavier Alexander guarding him, Cedric Oliver should really get his back to the basket and attack.
Lead goes back to Kaohsiung, 17-15. Wei Long, oh, he hits the three and they take the lead, 18-17.
That's a big shot there for Wong Wei Long, probably going to start getting him going.
1 point lead for the visiting team. Chang wisely giving it up to Luo.
Slingers continuing that full court pressure.
Luo gives it to Hall. out to Oliver. Inside to Jose. Good ball movement by the white shirts, and there's a foul against Singapore.
And again, they're deliberately trying to look for Raymar Jose inside the paint, but Kaohsiung has to work a little bit on their spacing. A lot of traffic inside the paint.
Two free throws will go Raymar Jose's way. 6'4", 210 pounds. Very young at the age of 25. First is a miss, though, for Jose.
Raymar Jose right now, third leading scorer. Sorry, make that fourth leading scorer for the squad, averaging 10 points per game.
Those are good numbers for Raymar Jose.
Especially coming in midway through the season.
Tied at 18 is our score. Offensive foul will be called against number 10, Leon Kwek.
And if that's on Kwek, that's going to be his second personal foul. Big development here for the Singapore Slingers as Desmond Oh checking in for the first time together with Achi Inigo. Now seeing action here for the Kaohsiung Truth.
Interesting, because Inigo didn't play in that game last Wednesday. A steal by Alexander, the flush down, and they have a two-point lead, 20-18.
Achi Inigo showing a little bit of rust there. Weak pass there, easily picked off by Alexander.
They go inside to Jose. He likes this matchup. Jose throws it up. Battle for the rebound, won by Howard. On the other side, Wei Long. They'll go for the three. And one more try for Singapore this time around. Howard makes sure of that.
And that is what Singapore loves to do. Justin Howard averages about 19 rebounds per game. Number one rebounder in the league.
And so I think referee Wai Seong Chan was talking to Justin Howard earlier, making sure that he doesn't do that again, or else he might be called for a technical for a delay of game.
That was going to be a warning on delay of game, and Justin Howard continuing to talk to the referee.
Under a minute to play here in the first, four-point lead for Singapore. Chang for the layup.
And there you see that two-man game between Derek Hall and Chang. Howard not as mobile in the perimeter. Wide open driving lane for Chang.
35 ticks to go here in the first. Hanbin hit one earlier, and he hits one again.
That's back-to-back three-point shots for Hanbin Ang, and he is one of the guys who can take advantage of this 2-3 zone by the Truth.
Five-point lead for the Slingers, 25-20. There's a five-second difference between shot clock and quarter clock. Chang with a miss. The putback by Jose is good, and he'll get a bonus free throw.
We know that Raymar Jose loves that, loves to crash that offensive glass. That time getting inside position against Hanbin Ang.
Earlier the steal of Alexander and the flush down by the power import. Beautiful, beautiful dunk by Xavier Alexander.
Alexander with 6 points, 3 out of 4 from the field.
Jose, bonus free throw is out.
Struggling from the free throw line is Raymar Jose. 1 out of 3.
Final 4 seconds of the quarter. Wei Long all the way from the parking lot. It's a big three coming from Wei Long. And that's a 5 or 6 point lead for the Singapore Slingers after the first 10 minutes of action. Wei Long with a long three. It deserves another look. Nothing but the bottom of the net. 28 for Singapore, 22 for Kaohsiung. First quarter ended with Singapore Slingers having a six-point lead, 28-22, thanks to the long three by Wong Wei Long. And he is really doing a good job in orchestrating the plays for Singapore and chipping in some points as well.
Really good shooting for the Singapore Slingers, shooting about 63% from the three-point area. They'll make that 3 out of 7 from the three-point area. Derek Hall continues to hit from the outside, but Kaohsiung already with 4 turnovers, leading to 6 turnover points for the Slingers.
If I'm not mistaken, that's a 9th point by Derek Hall. It started, his scoring started with the magical layup to beat the clock. And then from then on, he's been shooting well from the outside. Another look at that sweet shooting, Derek Hall, swish.
That was a good screen by Achi Nigo to get Justin Howard off balance. But on the other end, Justin Howard again capitalizing on his heft inside the paint, draws the foul from Derek Hall and makes the first free throw.
Already 3 of 3, am I right, in the visit to the line for Justin Howard? And I hope I did not jinx it. 4 of 4 for Justin Howard.
And here's this full court pressure here coming from Singapore.
Uh-oh, another steal by Alexander. That's the second time that Achi lost the ball.
Second turnover from Achi Inigo.
On the other side, Derek Hall going to Oliver. Cedric will be called for the offensive foul, and credit goes to Wei Long for staying in front of Cedric.
And a Slinger starting out this quarter well, forcing turnovers there. Second turnover for Kaohsiung, rather. Here's that offensive foul drawn by Wong Wei Long.
So Achi Inigo has been called back to the bench and taking his place as Shin. 32-24, an 8-point lead for the visiting team.
Kaohsiung sticking with that 2-3 zone.
Wei Long, another long three. That's an air ball. Hanbin has it with 5 to shoot. The kick out to Alexander. The 3-ball is out. And Hall gets the board.
And again, that's okay if you're Kaohsiung. Alexander not known for his three-point shot. So you're going to give that to him rather than give it to Desmond Oh or Wong Wei Long.
Jose against Hanbin. Jose missing that one. And he's having this difficulty against Hanbin.
Well, Hanbin also a physical player and just about as tall as Raymar Jose.
Wei Long out to Hanbin. They swing it around. Desmond Oh back to Hanbin for the three. That's the 3rd three of Hanbin.
So far perfect from the three-point stripe. Great ball movement there from Singapore from right to left. And then the penetration and kick out from Desmond Oh.
Biggest lead here for Singapore, 11, 35, 24. Jay Wei, the bump. And that was an offensive foul on Jay Wei.
And again, the perimeter players of Singapore, Wong Wei Long and Desmond Oh, playing excellent defense. Here's that penetration, 1 dribble, kick out to the top of the key. Hanbin Nang obliges with another 3-point shot.
8:16 to go here in the second quarter, and this has been a 7-2 run by the Slingers.
And a new face on the floor here, Rolando Gardner, who is the new heritage import for the Singapore Slingers. I was talking to him at the start of the ball game. He hails from Oklahoma City, grew up playing basketball with Xavier Alexander, and is getting his first crack here in the ABL.
And what's his nickname?
Roe
Gardner.
Also played college basketball in Kansas, so he just graduated, and first time here playing in Asia.
So interesting how he'll chip in this good game by the Slingers and how he'll work with Desmond Oh.
Yeah, and I was also talking to Coach Neo Beng Xiang, and he doesn't expect that much right away from Rogue Gardner. He expects him to just get his legs under him, play a backup role so far for Wong Wei Long, play solid minutes, and try to get a feed of the game and the system that the Slingers run.
Wesley on the drive. Short on that one. Desmond on the run. Howard asking for it. He gets it. The layup is good.
And you love it when your big man, especially Justin Howard, runs the floor in transition. Slingers looking to run off of every turnover or miss by the truth.
37-24. Still in favor of Singapore. Shin for the three. Gets his own miss. The pass deflected by Howard.
Quick hands there from Justin Howard.
Desmond wisely waiting for the big guy inside. Extra pass to the corner had been heat check. So this is a 9-2 run here, Coach Marco.
And yeah, we talked about the rust factor. So far, Slingers playing really well, sticking to their system.
Jay Way lost control of the ball. And according to referee John Tapa, that was a traveling violation on Jay Way.
And Coach Sabatino Chen giving Oliver a bit of a breather. So a crucial stretch here for the Truth. Oliver has not yet gotten his game going.
And taking his place is Brewster, Lee Wei Min, number 66. Howard picked up that ball, lost by Alexander, and Alexander smiling to his partner, saying thank you for making the basket.
And Justin Howard entering double digits, 10 points in the ball game for the big man.
39-24 with 6:17 to go here in the second. Hall with a left-handed hook, and it drops.
And that's a tough, tough shot there for Derek Hall.
Hanbin gives it to Cardner. Back to Hanbin. Deflected by Hall.
No numbers for the Truth.
They go down low to Derek. The extra pass to Jay Way. Falls down. No whistle.
Good challenge from Justin Howard.
5-4 here. Volkov. Nope. And look at Justin Howard just picking that ball. They have another 10 seconds to operate.
The Slingers, one of the best rebounding teams here in the ABL. They average about 48, close to 50 rebounds per game.
Oh, this was the slip earlier by Alexander, then the basket by Justin Howard.
That was a good recovery. Here's that left hook from the waist of Derek Hall.
They'll take that. Meantime, the reverse, all glass. Ball goes to the white shirts. Shin. Hall has it. Quickly to Chang at the corner. Missed the three.
And you know, Chang has been cold the past couple of games.
Go inside to Hall against Howard. Another hook. That was a miss. On the other side, Leon Quek. Basket is good, and he'll get a bonus free throw.
And you look at the pressure that Singapore puts on the Kaohsiung defense, looking to run every miss. Quek getting the basket and now heading to the line.
So in 5 minutes and 2 seconds, Coach Marco, Singapore has scored 13, while Kaohsiung has scored only 4 points. It's 41-26 in favor of the Singapore Slingers. Huge second quarter for the visiting Singapore Slingers here at the Kaohsiung Municipal Senior High School as they're up 41-26. And the home team, Kaohsiung Truth, they're trying to find their form. It was a nice first quarter for them, Coach Marco. But here in the second quarter, they've gone cold.
Yes, and they're allowing Singapore to get their way, especially on offense. Singapore has scored 11 points, as you mentioned, Chicky, to just 4 points by the Kaohsiung Truth. 2-1 full court pressure here from the Slingers, and this defense of the Slingers have really thrown Kaohsiung out of their game. Kaohsiung struggling on offense. They've only shot 1 out of 5 from the three-point area, 11 of 19 from the field, but they have not really gotten a flow, especially Cedric Oliver and Wesley Su.
No, they're missing, I'm very sure they're missing the services of a healthy Achi Inigo.
Yes, Achi Inigo has not gotten his rhythm.
Oliver out to Hall, and the outside shot is falling for the big guy.
And he has been one of the few bright spots here for the Kaohsiung Truth, keeping them within striking distance, down by 13.
4:23 to go here in the first half. Kwek is open, that short jumper, another basket for Leon Kwek.
And that free throw line area has been wide open, whether it's Justin Howard, that time Leon Kwek.
You know what, Coach Marco, we were talking about this off the air. I'm missing the happy factor here in the game of Kaohsiung Truth. My observation is that they're playing tense as compared to that game last Wednesday.
That's a good point, Chicky. The defense of Singapore really forcing them to struggle. This defensive pressure, especially the man-to-man, throwing them off their game. They're trying to force things, trying to force it to their go-to guys who have not yet been effective so far. Probably want to try to get more movement, get a more free-flowing offense, try to capitalize on Derek Hall's shooting and to attack the weaknesses of Singapore.
Good ball movement by the white shirts, but good defense as well by the Slingers. 3:37 to go, Coach Marco. They're down by 15. What would be a good target for the white shirts to end the first half?
Well, hopefully if they can get it to below 10, to close out the first half, get him some confidence going to the third quarter. And Cedric Oliver's jump shot has been flat so far, even against a smaller defender.
They need more of those points from Cedric. Meantime, Volkov. They go to Alexander, inside to Howard. That good ball movement by Singapore. Howard just tapping it to himself, but he lost it.
But again, that was a wide open shot from Leon Kwek patrolling the baseline. Once the ball goes in to Justin Howard, defense collapses, leaving his other teammates wide open.
That was a nice fake coming from Derek Hall, fooling Leon Kwek, but unfortunately it backfired and he lost it.
And Derek Hall really working here in the first half.
3 minutes remaining here in the second quarter. Still a big lead here, 15 points. For the Slingers, 43-28. And Coach Marco mentioned already, if they could cut this down, talking about the truth, cut this down to less than 10, then it would be something positive that they could build on in the third quarter.
One of the things that they have to improve on in the second half is their turnover number. Already with 10 turnovers in the ball game is the Kaohsiung Truth. They average about 15 turnovers per game. These 10 turnovers have resulted in 10 turnover points coming from the Singapore Slingers. So that defense, that man-to-man, that full-court pressure, really throwing Kaohsiung off their game.
So for the kids who are tuned in right now, Coach Mark with 10 turnover and 10 turnover points. 10 turnovers, rather, 10 turnover points.
50% conversion rate for the Singapore Slingers.
High post. So that's a reason, one of the reasons why they're up by 15. That's Coach Abatino Chen still very optimistic.
Let's go. Talk. Come on.
In this game.
Get back
they
in
just have
moving.
To get a couple of
taking
baskets going
shots.
Here to close out the
team
second
three.
Quarter.
1, 2, 3.
With 3 minutes left. Maybe off the pressure defense, try to get a couple of layups with Derek Hall playing the perimeter and Cedric Oliver also playing the perimeter. They might be able to get some back screens, some back cuts for Chang, for Luo, even for Wesley Su.
Lots of things on the plate now of Coach Abatino Chen and the rest of the Kaohsiung Truth. But the good thing is, in spite of a 15-point deficit, they have under 3 minutes remaining in the first half and a full 20 in the second half.
Love the patience coming from the Slingers.
Oh. Good rebound coming from Justin Howard. But I think that ball hit the backboard.
Yep, referee Bong Pascual corrects his initial call, gives it to the Truth.
2:38 to go here in the first half. Oh, really tight defense being shown here by the Slingers. Luo against Rowe. Luo on the move. Smart move by Luo. He heard the whistle.
Yeah, but that's what we're talking about. Because of the sticky man-to-man defense, once you beat your man, there's nobody there, especially with Derek Hall playing the perimeter, there's nobody there to block you. And that was a good move by Luo, drawing the foul, and then now he heads to the free throw line.
Down by 15 are the truth. It's down to 14.
First trip to the stripe here for Luo.
Second one is also good. They're looking for this spark plug, the Energizer Bunny. 2-for-2 for the point guard. Lead is down to 13, 43-30.
Truth have to make a stop here.
Uh-oh. That was like a shooting practice for Leon Quick.
And you know, that's a bad foul there on the part of Luo. And I don't see why he tries to pressure Xavier Alexander from beyond the three-point spot, leaving Leon Quick wide open on the elbow.
Another look at that smart move by Leon Quick. And he has shown a good account of himself for this year's ASEAN Basketball League.
Leon Quick already with 10 points in the game.
Was unable to convert that bonus free throw, but they have another 15-point lead. Wesley, back to Oliver. Cedric will use the glass, it's out. Good rebound by Chan.
And you know, Chicky, what is so dangerous about this pressure defense by the Slingers is you have Xavier Alexander manning the top, so he's so athletic, so long. Very difficult to pass over Xavier Alexander.
Whiteshirts lost the ball. Howard inside. Great entry pass coming from Folkoff.
And you know, Justin Howard, despite his heft, beating Derek Hall inside the paint. Good recognition from Mitchell Folkoff.
If I'm not mistaken, he's the biggest leader really by Singapore at 17. 47-30.
Looks like it's going to be an offensive foul on Mitchell Folkoff trying to fight through the screens. There's that play once again. And when your big man runs the floor, it's good to reward him.
Coach Sabatino Chen continuing to shuffle his point guards, his guards, trying to find the best person to probably orchestrate truth.
To break that pressure defense.
A minute 22 to go here in the first half. Wesley out to Oliver. Shot clock down to two. Cedric has to throw this one up, and there goes the buzzer. It's a 24-second shot clock violation.
And again, the pressure defense employed by the Slingers giving Kaohsiung Truth all sorts of problems on offense. That is the 12th turnover here for the Kaohsiung Truth.
Coach Sabatino Chen will give Achi Inigo another chance here with 70 seconds remaining in the second quarter.
And Coach Neo Bengshan getting Xavier Alexander that the extra minute of rest here in the first half.
Almost a steal by Chang. Wei Long on the move. The floater will drop for Wei Long.
And we talked about this during the break, Chicky. Wong Wei Long, not a flashy point guard, but very effective that time. Saw the pressure from Jay Wei, two dribbles, and then the floater inside the paint.
19-point lead is down to 17 because of the basket by Cedric.
Cedric Oliver finally gets one inside the paint against a smaller Folkoff. Here's that drive once again. Couple of dribbles, nice use of the hop step, and then the floater from Wong Wei Long.
And on the other side, Cedric Oliver quickly taking it back. Plus a chance to go for a three-point play with this bonus free throw. 8 points for Cedric. Make that nine as he converts on the bonus free throw. 49-33.
Two more possessions here in the first half.
Half a minute remaining here in the second. Wei Long. They go to Quick, inside to Howard. Oh, turnover there for the Redshirts. Jose picks up the loose ball. Cedric will set this one up with 11 on their shot clock, also on the quarter clock.
Asking for the ball screen here.
Cedric will take the jumper. Not there. And there goes the buzzer. The first 20 minutes of action is done. It's over. And the visiting team, Singapore Stingers, they're up by 16, 49 to 33, led by big man Justin Howard manning the paint. But the white shirts, the home team, not giving up, led by Cedric Oliver.
Both ends of the floor,
offense and defense. That's the reason why they have a big lead after the first 20 minutes of action, 49-33. Cedric Oliver trying to do a little bit of everything here just to save this match from slipping away off their hands, together with Luo Junquan. But Coach Abadina Chen trying to find the best combination on the floor, because Hanbin and Xavier Alexander have other things in mind. They want to continue being on top with an 8-2 record. And this is your ASEAN Basketball League match between Kaohsiung Truth and Singapore Stingers here at the Kaohsiung Municipal Senior High School. The 3rd of February, the 2nd of 3 games of Kaohsiung Truth in 5 days. They won against Saigon last February 1. This is their second match before they meet Malaysia on Sunday. And in the first 20 minutes of action, it is Singapore Stingers up by 16, 49-33.
You know, it's been a great first half. We talked about whether Singapore would show some signs of rust, but they have not lost any step here. Big high scoring first half here for the Stingers. 28 points in the first quarter, 21 in the second, and they have held Kaohsiung to just 11 points in that second quarter. Very telling quarter here. We're talking about the struggles of the Kaohsiung Truth, really having a hard time orchestrating on offense. Meanwhile, for the Stingers, very fluid on offense, finding, very patient, finding the open man, going inside and out. And Leon Kwek, Justin Howard, even Wong Wei Long have responded to the call.
It's so difficult to choose who you're going to guard on the side of Singapore. You mentioned those names already. Leon Kwek, you got Hanbin, Alexander, Howard, Wei Long. Everyone that Coach Leo brings in or puts on the floor, they have responded well to the challenge. Numbers here, Coach Marco, and it's tilting to the side of the Singapore Slingers.
Oh yes, definitely. You take a look at the field goals, 14 of 31 for Kaohsiung, 20 of 37 for the Singapore Slingers. They're shooting at about 55% from the three-point area, just 1 out of 5 to the Kaohsiung Truth when they are actually the better three-point shooting team. They average about 33% from the three-point area. Meanwhile, the Singapore Slingers, who only average about 30%, they're fourth in the league, shooting close to 4 out of 6, or sorry, close to 5 out of 12, close to 50% of the three-point area. So Kaohsiung has to do a better job pressuring the ball handler. They have to do a better job packing it inside the paint and getting the rebounds. Justin Howard leading the way for the Singapore Slingers with 12. Leon Breck with 10. Wong Wei Long with 10 points. Xavier Alexander with 8. And Han Bin Nam, who has been a revelation off the bench, 9 points on 3 out of 3 from the three-point area.
Balanced scoring for the Singapore Slingers. Imagine 3 players combining for 32 of their 49. All on the other side, yes, Derek Hall and Cedric Oliver are doing their stuff, but we're missing the support of the other players.
That is true. We talked about for the Kaohsiung Truth and Singapore Slingers, for that matter, their main guns, their starters, 4 out of their 5 starters, they average majority of their points right now. It is Raymar Jose and Wesley Su who have been quiet for the Kaohsiung Truth, and it has been Derek Hall who has been carrying the scoring load for the Truth. Derek Hall already with 13 points, but Cedric Oliver with 9.
Things in life is to be different. It's not easy to step out and do something that the next person is not doing.
You know, I grew up as a kid, you know, looking at the NBA, dreaming hopefully one day I can get there. I grew up watching All-Star games and, you know, thinking that'd be cool, you know, if I can make it there. And now I'm 11 years in consecutively, so you try not to take it for granted. You know, you understand that nothing is guaranteed to you. So I'm thankful.
Don't be afraid to be different, man. That's what Make Your Own Way stands for. Your way. Everybody's is different. Everybody got a different story. You might be from the same block. You might be from the same park, the same neighborhood, whatever the case may be. But everybody got a different path.
I think what Dwayne and Li Ning are doing for these kids is unbelievable, man. I think we need more of those type of people that are not afraid to sacrifice something that's cool for something that can have a positive effect on so many others, and most importantly, a younger generation.
D-Wade coming to my high school, it means the greatest thing in the world, basically. And he's giving back to me, like this room, before he gave back to this room, it was really small. Now it just looks excellent, it looks the best. And D-Wade coming to my school, personally, that's just the greatest thing to ever happen, because most people, when they make it, they don't come back.
What these kids get to learn in these moments is not just how to put a ball in a hoop. They learn how to be themselves, be confident and competent in any arena. It's coming.
Make Your Own Way to me is kind of like paving your own path to greatness.
Be a leader, kind of follower.
To inspire other people to lead by example.
Challenging my team to find the need in the community, you know, without youth. And, you know, going around and trying to, you know, figure it out, man. And, you know, we always try to leave an impact. You know, every time we come to a city, I know how important that is. You know, it can be something small, man, just by seeing someone come to your school or see someone care about you enough, it can change your whole outlook on life, you know. So I've been there before and I get it.
Hall, Derek Hall to Jose. Jose crossover spins. A great shot Raymond Jose, the man who went to Far Eastern University and studied sports management.
The Dragons again, Ben settling for an outside jump shot.
Rala Filipinas, as we are now up by 7, 25-18. Mitchell Foco against, oh, nice step back move by Foco, and he knocks it down.
Excellent move there against Bobby Ray Parks. Foco using his heft to create some space on the step back.
Yeah.
Kaohsiung City, Taiwan, for another coverage of the ASEAN Basketball League. And our venue is the Kaohsiung Municipal Senior High School for this match between the home team, Kaohsiung Truth, and the visiting team, Singapore Slingers. Basketball fans, good day to all of you. Chicky Reyes here with Marco Benitez. And after the first 20 minutes of action, the Singapore Slingers are just too much for the Truth. They have a 16-point lead, 49-33.
And you know, so far, Kaohsiung has not given the home crowd a lot to cheer about. 12 turnovers in the first half, allowing 49 points for the Singapore Slingers, and more than that, too easy for the Singapore Slingers, especially on offense. Meanwhile, Kaohsiung having a hard time getting a good flow to their offense.
The lead went up as high as 19 at one point. And the target that Coach Mark and I were talking about less than 10 didn't happen for the Truth.
And you know what, one of the things that has been working for the Slingers is they love to run in transition, off of misses, off of turnovers. Because you have a Xavier Alexander who can push the ball up the floor, put so much pressure on the defense to try to get back. That sequence, another example, Alexander was the one who brought the ball up the floor. You have Mitchell Folkoff running on the left wing, and then it was up to Alexander to drop off the pass, and Mitchell Folkoff finishing strong and drawing the foul.
And Folkoff makes the first of two free throws, making it 50 for Singapore, 33 for Kaohsiung.
Let's see if Kaohsiung can start out strong here in the third quarter. So far, it has been all Slingers, and they have yet to solve this full court pressure.
2-for-2 for Mitchell, 51-33, Singapore. Wesley being guarded tightly from beyond the arc. He forces this one, and it's good.
And hopefully that will get Wesley Su going. Wesley Su just with 2 points. We got 4 points in the ball game. Kaohsiung sticking to their 2-3 zone.
1 minute has gone by here in the third. Wei Long, another three ball from the point guard of Singapore.
And we talked about the stellar outside shooting of the Singapore Slingers right now. 6 of 14 from the three-point area, and they're just moving the ball around.
Derek Hall takes it back.
One of the few bright spots for the Kaohsiung Truth, Derek Hall, right now with 16 points, leading all scorers for the Truth.
And they have to feed off that energy of Derek Hall.
And they have to take advantage of when Hall brings Justin Howard outside the paint. They have to try to get some penetrations going.
Shot block down to 6 for Singapore. Folkoff. Tight pass inside. Completed steal here by Kaohsiung.
And this has been the difference between the two teams. Kaohsiung, whenever they get a miss or a turnover, slowly brings it up the floor, except for this time, Jay Wei finding an open lane to the basket. But the Slingers, every time a miss or a make or a miss or a turnover happens, they're looking to push and score in transition.
Lead is down to 14. The kick out. Wei Long with a floater. Missed that one. And rebound goes to Oliver.
Then again, that was a hard close out there by Shin. Open lane by Wong Wei Long, just missed the floater.
Jay Wei to Derek Hall. That's a miss by Hall. Ball goes back here to Singapore. Leon Kwek all the way, giving it to Alexander. There goes the flush down.
And you saw that sequence once again. Off the miss, Wong Wei Long looking to push. You had Xavier Alexander, Leon Kwek running the wings, Howard in the middle. Easy 2 points, easy flush for the X-Man.
10 points for Alexander. And the lead is up to 16 again. Inside to Cedric, took advantage of that mismatch against Quick.
That was a good high-low play there. You can use Derek Hall as the facilitator because Justin Howard is going to come out on him. So try to take advantage of the mismatches created by that scenario.
The pass inside, read by Oliver. Turnover for the red shirts. Oh, too weak of a pass coming from Shin. Folkoff on the other side, the feed to Howard, and the miss. But he'll go to the free throw line.
Justin Howard frustrated at himself there. Almost easy 2 points, almost a three-point play. Here's that penetration once again by Jay Wei, one of the few penetrations we've seen here from the Truth.
Hanbin is back, replacing Mitchell Folkoff.
So far, Hanbin has been an efficient game. I believe
Well, he's 3 out of 5 from the field, 3 out of 4 from the three-point area. It's a very efficient outing.
Howard made the first. The second is also good.
Justin Howard so far perfect from the stripe, 6 out of 6 today. Achienigo checking back into the ballgame, so it's a two-point guard backcourt for the truth.
58-42, still Singapore.
Another turnover here.
8-second violation. How often do you see that in the ABL?
Not that often, because normally teams are able to break the press that time. A little tentative on the release pass was Derek Hall.
Oh, a turnover by Wei Long, picked up by Inigo. Feeding Hall. Hall with a Euro step, and basket is good. He's asking for a foul.
Good find there from Achi Inigo.
Lead is down to 14 again, 58-44.
Let's see if the truth can string a couple of baskets, but it has to start here on the defensive end.
Quick kick out by Howard. Quick ball movement by Singapore. Inside to Howard. And quick hands there from Derek Hall.
That's good help defense there on the part of Cedric Oliver.
Meantime, Wesley Hsu changing direction. Alexander's all over him. Shot knocked down to 11. Inside to Cedric. The baby hook, and that's the miss. They go to the corner. Hall, or rather, Cedric hits the three.
First three-pointer of the ball game for Cedric Oliver. And what a time for it to come. Hopefully that will get him going.
The lead is down to 11, 58-47 with 5:36 to go here in the third quarter. And the truth, they have awoken here in the third. They're only down by 11 points. Back here at the Kaohsiung Municipal Senior High School. We have a ball game here, Coach Marco. And the truth, they're only down by 11 points.
Yep, that is true, Chicky. First time in the ball game that the truth have outscored the Slingers in a quarter. Right now, 14-9 here in the third.
Wei Long using the glass. That's a difficult shot.
A very difficult shot there. Using the glass from the top of the key after the challenge of Achi Inigo. Wong Wei Long now with 15 points in the game.
60-47, back to a 13-point lead here for the Redshirts. Wesley Hsu slipping. And that will be a turnover for the truth.
And that is going to be turnover number 15, so that is right up their average. Wesley Hsu has not really gotten his game going here for the truth. Raymar Jose checking back in.
So Achi Inigo is on the floor, joined by Shin, Jose, Oliver, and Hall. Probably a tough five here for Coach Abatino Chin, but an equally tough five on the other side.
So they're going to try to match up against the backcourt of Desmond Oh and Wong Wei Long with the two-point guards, Shin and Inigo.
11 to shoot. Hard pass inside to Howard.
Right idea there by Wong Wei Long, but Howard not ready for the pass. Here's the pressure from the Slingers.
And these are the chances, Coach Mark, or the opportunities that the truth should capitalize on.
They can cut this down to 11 or even just 10 points here, middle of the third quarter.
Hall, lots of fakes. Foul will be called against Howard. And Derek Hall will go to the free throw line.
One of the few times that Hall has tried to attack Justin Howard inside the paint. Here's that up and under move from Derek Hall.
Normally, he gets to push away some of his defenders, but against Justin Howard, Howard is just too strong as well.
Yep, and good break there for Derek Hall. Already with 18, I think that 19 points in the ball game.
So split for Hall in that last visit, the 4.5-meter line. Still a 12-point lead here for Singapore with 4:25 to go here in the third.
And so far, this more active 2-3 zone has been working. Well, that's going to be a foul. I believe it's going to be on Derek Hall.
Good intention coming from Raymar Jose to double and help. But quick step coming from the big guy, forcing Hall to give up a foul. 14 to shoot for Singapore with 4:16 to go in the third. Wei Long will set this one up. Alexander has it, hard drive, and you simply love Saber Alexander every time he does that.
Oh yes, he's one of the strongest to the basket and most aggressive that time. Nobody there to block the driving lane of Saber Alexander. Almost wide open, right through the middle, poke and defense. That's what coaches will tell you. One of the times that you need to sacrifice your body to draw the charge and not just settle for those swipes.
That's how intelligent Alexander is. He saw that opening, took advantage, an easy two for Alexander. A miss by Hall, battle for the rebound, won by Oliver, off the glass. Now, they're doing well on offense, but they can't keep on exchanging baskets here.
Yes, that's very true. They need to make a stop. One of the few times that they've gotten that offensive rebound.
62-50, 3.5 to go in the third. Almost a steal by Oliver. Hanbin, back to Wei Long with 10 to shoot. The pass inside deflected by Hall. And last touch will be called against Oliver. 5 on the shot clock for the Slingers.
Here's that possession once again. Raymar Jose and Cedric Oliver battling against Alexander.
Shot clock down to 3. Hanbin blocked by Jay Wei. Jose finding Wei. Good transition defense coming from Singapore, and a foul will be called against Wei Long.
No choice there for Wong Wei Long. Definitely a mismatch against Raymar Jose in the post. For a second, Cedric Oliver was wide open under the basket.
So Hanbin sits down, Leon Kwek is back. So it's a shooter for a shooter. More problems here for Kaohsiung. Chang, the hook pass to Oliver, good recognition and good finish.
And a good roll there coming from Cedric Oliver. Familiarity between these two Kaohsiung Truth players. So taller backcourt here now with Jay Wei and Chang.
Now the lead is down to 10, 62-52.
And so far they've done a better job clogging that free throw area. There's a good challenge from Raymar Jose.
Miss by Oh. Paul is running, Jose did not see him. Raymar will go all the way and it's a miss.
Has a four shot there coming from Raymar Jose.
Alexander blocked by Oliver. Counterattack here by Kaohsiung. Jay Wei finding Hall. Inside pass to Oliver.
Had an open shot there from about 10 feet.
And Desmond Oh will be called for a traveling violation.
Let's see that sequence once again. Here's that great left-handed pass to the rolling Cedric Oliver.
So a chance here for Kaohsiung to trim the deficit to less than 10. Cedric inside, the baby hook won't drop. And Howard lost control of the ball. So another chance here for the home team.
Well, what I like about what Kaohsiung is doing is they are drawing Justin Howard outside the paint and they are trying to attack either off of Cedric Oliver or another perimeter player in a Chang or even Jay Wei.
kickball violation. So Kaohsiung will keep possession with 14 on the shot clock.
Another matchup they may have the advantage with is Raymar Jose against Leon Kwek.
But Raymar hasn't really found this rhythm here,
yeah,
Marco.
That's correct.
Well, here we go. Hall gives it to Chang. Chang is open for the three. Still couldn't buy a basket, and somebody was holding the shirt of Raymar Jose.
Looked like Leon Kwek, but referee not seeing that. Here's Singapore in transition. Good transition defense here by the white shirts.
Alexander has it, way long. Howard. Oh, nobody guarded Leon Kwek underneath.
And that is what Leon Kwek loves to do. He loves to patrol that baseline, whether it's within 5 feet or that short corner. Very effective is Leon Kwek.
127 remaining in the third. The lead goes back up to 12. Chang. They go inside to Jose. Jose will bully his way against Kwek. He gets the basket. He'll get a bonus free throw.
And that's what we're talking about. As long as you space the floor really well, with Derek Hall's shooting, Howard forced to come out, it's going to be a one-on-one for Raymar Jose in the paint against Leon Kwek.
64-54, 77 seconds remaining in the third. Chance here for the truth to trim this down to 9 should Raymar make the bonus free throw.
That's going to be the third personal foul on Leon Kwek.
So something positive here, Coach Marco. They started the third down by 16. Now they're down by just 9.
Slowly inching their way back into this ball game are the Kaohsiung Truth.
Way long. 2-0. They have 7 to operate. Alexander, 4 to shoot. Good help. The pass to Desmond. Good defense by Derek Hall. White shirts on the run.
4-on-2.
They go to Shin for the 3. Nope. Would have been big. The leak out play. Alexander could not control the pass.
That was a good job by Shin to get back in transition and distract Xavier Alexander there. Almost automatic 2 points had he fielded that pass.
39.8 remaining in the third. Just a 9-point lead for the Slingers.
So the Kaohsiung Truth have turned this quarter around from being outscored 11-4. Right now they're outscoring the Slingers 22-15 here in the third.
The kick out to Shin, inside to Hall again. The baby hook is good and the lead is down to 7.
That's a good quick move, good entry pass coming from Shin.
And I like his demeanor. Talking about Shin, he's smiling, he's relaxed. Finding the right guy at the right time.
That's the right type of body language that Kaohsiung needs. Derek Hall, meanwhile, with 21 points.
12 seconds remaining in the third. Just a 7-point lead for Singapore, 64-57. It's down to 6. And a foul will be called against Shin. Good foul, actually.
Not yet in the penalty yard, the Kaohsiung Truth. Just the 4th team foul. Meanwhile, for Shin, that is only his 2nd personal.
Lots of time here for Singapore to operate. 6 seconds remaining. Third quarter action here. Way long for the long 3. Missed it completely. And there goes the buzzer. The first 30 minutes of action is over. We have a ball game here with Singapore only up by 7 points, 64-57. The Truth are alive in this match, led by Raymar Jose and Derek Hall. 7 is our score after 30 minutes of action. The lead is down to 7 for the Slingers after leading by as much as 19. And the truth, they actually have a good chance in stealing another win.
And you know, they did it, Chicky, on defense. That was the only quarter where the Kaohsiung Truth were able to hold the Singapore Slingers to below 20 points, just 15 points for the Slingers in that quarter. And it was a good adjustment, especially in that free throw line area. They were not as successful, talking about the Slingers, in scoring or converting or hitting that free throw line area.
It's Oliver, Shin, Jose, Wei, and Hall for the white shirts. Jose has it, shot locked down to 4. Jose with a baby hook, and they'll call him for steps.
That's good defense there coming from Xavier Alexander.
Now on the other side, it's Quek, Wei Long, Alexander, Hanbin, and Justin Howard. Final quarter of this match. It's the number one team versus the current number 4. Howard looking for the open guy. Wei Long has it. Good cover by Shin. Still Wei Long. Hanbin is open for the 3, and you know the result.
Not the guy you want to leave wide open. 4 out of 5 from the 3-point area is Hanbin Ng. Already with 12 points in the ball game.
The lead goes back up to 10. 57 for Kaohsiung, 67 for Singapore. Cedric looking for Jose, couldn't find him. Hall will take the outside shot. It won't drop. Jose for the offensive board. They'll have another crack here.
And they're trying to look for Derek Hall in the post.
Cedric hits the 3.
That's a big shot there, especially matched up against Justin Howard.
The lead goes down to 7, 67-60.
And Coach Neo Bengshang sending Justin Howard or Leon Quek to that free throw line.
Howard back to Wei Long. Wei Long. Justin puts the ball on the floor. He lost it, and ball goes back to Kaohsiung.
And if you're Kaohsiung, that's what you want Howard to do. Put the ball on the floor where he's less comfortable than taking that 10-footer.
Now Cedric hit that 3 only because Justin Howard allowed him to take that outside shot.
Yeah, that's a good read on the defense by Cedric Oliver. Good confidence on his stroke.
Wei setting the table. This time around, Oliver goes hard to the basket. Missed it, a tap out by Derek Hall, but ball will swing back to Singapore.
And Cedric's got to take it stronger to the basket, especially since he was able to blow by Xavier Alexander.
Roe Gardner is back on the floor. Being guarded tightly by Wei.
Yep, backup point guard here for Coach Neo Bengshan.
Shot clock down to 6. Xavier will take the jumper at the baseline. That's a miss. Look at Jose going for that rebound.
That's a monstrous rebound there coming from Raymar Jose. Let's see if Kaohsiung can capitalize.
Shin will take the 3. He missed it. There's a push on Hanbin.
And you love how Raymar Jose is battling inside the paint, whether it's against Leon Quek or Hanbin Ng. Really winning second chance opportunities here for the Kaohsiung Truth.
Now this will be big if they can convert.
And cut it down to a 2-possession ball game.
Down low to Hall, the baby hook. Nope, not there. Look at Jose battling for the rebound. Shin has it. Wei for 3. Air ball.
That's going to be a foul, I believe, on Derek Hall. Justin Howard puts an end to that possession.
So good foul thrown by Kaohsiung Truth to stop the play. And that was an empty possession earlier. Air ball thrown by Jay Wei. So it's not yet over here. Still not a safe lead here for Singapore Stingers. With 7:08 remaining in the match, they have a 7-point lead, 67-60. And we'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. Out here at the Kaohsiung Municipal Senior High School for this match between the home team, Kaohsiung Truth, and the visiting team, Singapore Stingers, for your ASEAN Basketball League. And great ABL action we're watching right now. It's now down to 7, talking about the lead of the Singapore Stingers.
You know, both teams trying to grind it out here on both offense and defense. They've only each scored 3 points here with 3 minutes gone in the fourth quarter.
So far, so good for the home team. They are within striking distance. Alexander at the baseline. Oh, he wanted to slam it home, but good help defense from Derek Hall.
That was a good, strong drive there from Xavier Alexander. No choice for Derek Hall but to foul him, otherwise risk getting posterized.
That was a huge opening given by Cedric Oliver.
We've seen that Alexander is the quicker of the two world imports.
He's on the line right now. First free throw is good.
13 points in the ball game for the X-Man. Balanced scoring, Chicky, for the Slingers. We have Wong Wei Long with 15, Quek with 12, Alexander with 13, Justin Howard with 14 points, and Han Bin Ng with 12.
So 5 players in double digits. Unbelievable. Split, however, for Alexander. So the lead has gone up to 8, 68-60.
Still a long time to go here.
Almost a steal there by Alexander. Shin, the lob pass to Raymar Jose. Dangerous pass, and Jose missed it.
Well, they tried to go to the mismatch, Raymar Jose against Mitchell Folkoff.
6:24 remaining in the match. Full call. Always going to Howard inside. Hanbin is again open, and that's the result.
And Cedric Oliver had to make the decision whether to get Xavier Alexander on the baseline or leave Hanbin Nang wide open. Shin also late on the closeout. Another three-point shot for Nang.
Fifth three-point shot. Am I right in my count?
Yep. 5 out of 6 from deep.
So 15 points from Rainbow Country for Hanbin, and earlier Jose with a miss. The lead is up to 11 again, 71-60.
And this is a point in the ball game where the Truth just have to stick with it and keep grinding. But that's going to be difficult as Hanbin Nang hits another three-point shot, 6 of 7.
So this has turned into a shooting practice here for Hanbin.
Well, you saw the adjustment of Coach Neo Beng Shan putting Justin Howard at the free throw stripe. Forces the defense to come out, and Howard has been great finding his open teammate.
Folkoff will be called for that foul, and Raymar Jose will go back to the free throw line. But the three-point shot of Hanbin, it deserves another look. Hit one earlier from the left side. He went to the right side, and it's the same result.
And both of those times, I believe it was Justin Howard gave him the pass.
So 2 assists for the big guy. 2 conversions for the sweet shooting Hanbin.
Raymar Jose adds to his total.
Lead is down to 13, 74, 61. It went down, Coach Marco, to a slow 7 points.
Kaohsiung allowing this game to slip slowly from their hands, but still half a quarter to go. Let's see if Alo and Achi Inigo in the backcourt can make some stops.
Next man with the ball. They're looking for Howard. Hanbin. Down low to the X-Man, that bump to create the extra space. They'll keep possession.
And I like how Alexander is the one that facilitates, because his height allows him to pass over the smaller defenders of Kaohsiung. And once he cuts inside, Han Binang releases to the wing. Has another three-point shot. 7 in the ball game. I think he's 7 out of 9.
Hanbin, another 3-ball. And that time around, I would say it was good defense already for Kaohsiung Truth.
And Hanbin now making great use of that 20-day break to work on his 3-point shot.
16-point lead for Singapore, 77-61. Luo challenging the defense here, a throw Gardner, and Gardner will be called for that foul. But another look here at the 3 of Hanbin.
There's a great baseline inbounds play. Wide open Hanbin on the left wing. Great find from Xavier Alexander.
And you have to agree with me, Hanbin moves well without that basketball. Yeah.
And because of his height, easy for him to catch and shoot over the smaller perimeter defenders of Kaohsiung.
And what I like about Hanbin is just he doesn't force his shots. If there's nothing there, he releases that basketball.
Just picks his spots. That's the way to break that 2-3 zone. Catch the ball, no shot available, move the ball around, find another open spot.
Now on the other side, unfortunately for Kaohsiung, Singapore will hit the 3, then they'll make 1 free throw on the other end. Not equal. Rowe, stop and pop, it's good.
That's another big shot there for Rowe.
79-62.
Rowe Gardner again, hailing from Oklahoma.
Luo will go for the 3. Missed it. A too soft of a pass coming from Hall.
Just better defensive effort for the Slingers here in the fourth quarter.
Now they're extending the defense outside to Hanbin. Shot clock down to 9. X-Man. And a foul will be called against Cedric Oliver. Howard made sure that he won't interfere with that pass.
And you know, that's just great patience there on the part of the Slingers, moving the ball from right to left. Hanbin now with the skip pass to Mitchell Folkoff. And then Xavier Alexander with the entry pass to Justin Howard.
Coach Sabatino Chen replacing Luo and Achi, putting in Shin and Chang. Hanbin, 7 threes. Fouled by Shin, and Hanbin will take 3 free throws.
And you see the patience coming from the Slingers. Ball goes in to Justin Howard. He surveys the floor, pivots, finds Hanbin on the weak side wing. That's a bad foul there coming from Shin.
If you're Shin, I mean, you really have to rush towards Hanbin after seeing him hit 7 threes and missing a couple only.
And you might have to think about allowing Derek Hall to just go one-on-one defending Justin Howard rather than risk another open shot from the wings of the Singapore Slingers.
Hanbin, that is so unlikely of a shooter to go 1 out of 2 from the free throw line after hitting 7 from way out. 80-62. 18-point lead here for Singapore. Hall has been quiet here in the fourth.
And that's going to be a traveling violation there from Derek Hall, just struggling inside the paint against Justin Howard.
3:05 remaining in the match. Howard has tightened up his defense against Derek Hall. This is an 18-point lead here for Singapore in the window of opportunity for Kaohsiung Truth. Coach Marco, it's getting smaller and smaller,
getting smaller in this match. Yep, and you can see from their body language, not really happy are the Kaohsiung Truth. after a great win against the Saigon Heat last Wednesday.
Really extend the zone.
Singapore Slingers really taking it to them here in their home floor.
Ball pressure. Anytime low post, we're trapping. Anytime they pass to the corner, we're trapping.
Still coaching, still giving instructions.
Coming, we're trapping. You gotta come over.
Hoping that they could get something positive out of this match. Okay. With only 3:05 remaining.
It's a steal. Okay.
They're down
pressure
by 18. Mathematically possible.
Guys, when we get it,
however,
a stop.
Without things are going for Singapore, both ends of the floor.
Or make baskets. Just get it out.
Especially on offense. Might be too tight for Kaohsiung.
Team on three. 1, 2, 3.
Save this game.
That's very true, Chicky. Especially if you're shooting just 4 out of 14 from the three-point area. Can't expect to overhaul an 18-point deficit in 3 minutes with the way, especially with the way Singapore has been playing, and with the patience that they've displayed. Coach Sabatino Chen trying to change things up. Looks like they're going to trap the corners and force Singapore to make hurried passes and try to get some quick turnovers here in the last 3 minutes.
You mentioned 4 of 14 from Rainbow Country, and Hanbin has converted 7. So he is 3 more than the total output or total conversion of Kaohsiung.
That's true.
From the three-point area.
Right now, turnover there from Mitchell Folkoff. Let's see if Kaohsiung can get something positive. But Singapore also still sticking with that man-to-man full-court pressure.
Under 3 minutes remaining in this match. Very comfortable 18-point lead here for the visiting team. Hanbin will be called for that foul against Wesley Su.
And Wesley Su has definitely been very quiet here. Just 4 points in the ballgame. Not able to get his game going. Not able to get those open looks, which he is so used to.
I'm pretty sure Singapore found out about his almost perfect offensive game the other day.
That's one of the reasons, I believe, why they've stuck to their man-to-man defense. Just to close out Wesley Su. That time, even though he got a shot off, it was good challenge coming from Hanbin.
2.5 remaining in the match.
Desmond Oh, who played really well as Jan 15 against Hong Kong, has been quiet, but it has not been needed.
Now, Justin Howard almost bringing the whole rim down with that dunk.
And that was an assist coming from Rogue Gardner.
And he gave us a smile, talking about Justin Howard. I thought it was going to fall down. It deserves another look.
Here's that play, bounce pass, and Howard tries to rip the rim down.
So this is the biggest lead down for Singapore, Coach Marco.
Derek Hall has been quiet here in the fourth quarter, cooling off here after stellar three quarters. Derek Hall, leading scorer for the Kaohsiung Truth with 21 points.
82-62, 20-point lead here for Singapore with a minute and 50 seconds remaining.
And you know, the important thing here, Chicky, is you're in the middle of a three-game home stand. You won your first, you're on your way to lose the second, but you have just a one-day rest, and you're going to be playing the rebooted Westport's Malaysia Dragons, whom we've heard have released Freddie Goldstein. We've yet to see who are they going to replace him with. But if you're Kaohsiung, you want to forget about this loss, try to learn from your mistakes, and get back and come out stronger against the Westport's Malaysia Dragons, whom you've defeated on Sunday.
That's going to be tough because they only have a one-day break going to that Sunday game. And right now they're facing a 22-point deficit, 84-62, with a minute 29 remaining in the match. And while we stay on this coverage, Coach Marco, what was the turning point here? I mean, after the first 30 minutes of action, Kaohsiung Truth was pretty much in the game, only being down by 7 at the turn of the third quarter.
Well, it was the way they closed out each half. First half, they closed out the second quarter. They were outscored 21-11. They played really well in the third, brought it down to as low as 7 points, outscored Singapore 24-15 in the third, but they've only scored 5 points here in the fourth quarter. So defense did it for Kaohsiung in the third quarter. Defense was what did it for the Singapore Slingers here in the fourth quarter. 20 points for the Slingers, 5 points only for the Kaohsiung Truth. They've cooled off after a hot shooting third quarter. And one of those guys who has remained hot, Hanbin Ang, shooting about 7 of 9 from the three-point area. 22 points for Han Binang. 7 of 10 from the field. 70% shooting for the swing man from Singapore.
And you mentioned 7 threes. 3 of those, if I am not mistaken, came here the fourth quarter.
That's true. And again, like you mentioned, none of those were forced. They were coming off the flow of the offense. They attacked the 2-3 zone of Kaohsiung really well, moved the ball around, and I believe two of those three-point shots were assisted by Justin Howard.
I was about to go there because more often than not, the credit always goes to the shooter. But Justin Howard, he has played this role. He has been the facilitator in their set plays. And on the other side, he has tightened that defense against Derek Hall,
yeah,
who has become cold and silent here in the fourth.
Justin Howard looking at his stats, 16 points, 5 of 8 from the field, 13 rebounds, 4 assists for the big man, and he has really changed a lot of shots on defense.
How about Raymar Jose? Not really a factor in this match.
Well, Raymar Jose tried to get going, attacking those mismatches, but you know, the height of Singapore, especially with Justin Howard, and the versatility of Xavier Alexander really making it difficult for Raymar Jose. Once he got away from his smaller defender, there was a lot of help defense there to really give him a hard time to finish his shots.
Let's go over to Cedric Oliver. We were mentioning in that February 1 game that although he missed a couple of shots, he was very effective as a facilitator. But by my observation in this match, he was outplayed by his counterpart, the X-Man.
Well, that's true. You know, despite 23 points from Cedric Oliver, 10 rebounds, just 2 assists for Cedric Oliver, Xavier Alexander, he's going to finish with 15 points, 8 rebounds, 7 assists. So better all-around performance here for Xavier Alexander. But the more important thing for me here was Xavier Alexander able to really more or less cancel out the performance of Cedric Oliver. It was only towards the latter portion of the game in the third quarter where Oliver was able to get going. But by that time, Singapore had a comfortable enough lead to just keep Kaohsiung at bay.
Under a minute to play in this match. We're just waiting for the final buzzer and the final score.
And you know, Chicky, with this impending loss by the Kaohsiung Truth, they are going to fall to 3-7. Westport's Malaysia Dragons right now at 2-6. So it's going to be a very crucial game on Sunday. If Westport is able to get a win somehow here in the home floor of Kaohsiung, they're going to tie each other up at the fourth spot at 3-7. So going towards the second half of this elimination round, both teams at the tied for number 4 with identical 3-7 records. So it's going to be an interesting second half of this elimination round for these two squads.
And we discussed that because the first to third teams are comfortably on top already. So it's really a battle for that fourth spot, at least at this point of the tournament. Well, there goes the buzzer. Our final score is 84-66, an 18-point victory by the Slingers in their first meeting against the Kaohsiung Truth. And they have occupied that top spot. They have solidified their position there. They are now at 9-2.
And you know, the final score does not really reflect the story of the ball game, especially through three quarters. It was only in the fourth quarter where Kaohsiung really cooled off, just scored 9 points in that fourth in the payoff period, while the Slingers waxed hot, scoring 20 points in the fourth quarter. So hats off to the Kaohsiung Truth for hanging in there. But the Singapore Slingers, that is the reason why they are the number one team in the league so far, able to play the entire 40 minutes and finishing with 84 points on offense.
Look at Cedric Oliver, always the leader of this squad in victory and in defeat. He always makes sure that everyone huddles up at the center court, gives his post-game pep talk, preparing everyone for that all-important match on Sunday. A lot of things that they could get out from this match, Coach Marco. Yes, they were defeated by 18. They lost by 18 points. But always, they always try to look for something positive, looking at things half-filled instead of half-empty.
Well, yes, and they saw the past couple of games where their 2-3 defense worked. They now played a team where that was able to break their 2-3 zone defense. So it's a game of adjustments. There's still 10 games left in the elimination round for the Kaohsiung Truth. So they're still very much in the thick of things. And let's see how they will fare on Sunday against the Westport's Malaysia Dragons.
It's not yet over. We are halfway through the elimination round of the ASEAN Basketball League. The teams are continuing to jockey for a position even in the 1, 2, and 3 spots. It's not yet over, but so far the men in red, the Singapore Slingers, have a good spot up there with a 9-2 record. And at the bottom, it's very interesting because even Saigon Heat is not yet out of the race, Coach Martin.
That's definitely correct. And let's see if Saigon, with their new world import, new heritage import in Moses Morgan, can get things back on track, still mathematically in the hunt for that fourth spot.
Again, the final score, 84 for Singapore Slingers, 66 for the home team, Kaohsiung Truth. First of four meetings here at the ABL, and it was just too much for Kaohsiung. Talking about these men in red, Justin Howard, the X-Man, Wei Long, Leon Kwek, everyone doing well for the Singapore Slingers. And this is where we end our coverage. On behalf of Debbie, my partner here, Marco Benitez, this is Chicky Reyes saying thank you very much for watching and enjoying this edition of your ASEAN Basketball League.